Hello students, today we will try to understand what is environmental quality management. Now let us first understand the concept. We all know that a quality environment is very, very important for us to survive in. A quality environment is very essential for a healthy and happy living. The environmental quality encompasses the following four broad areas. Number one is shelter. Shelter, which depends upon the quality and adequacy of residential, commercial and industrial buildings. Number two, public health and safety, which concerns the prevention of diseases, accidents and pollution of air, water, soil, etc. These days we are fighting a pandemic called COVID-19. So public health and safety is all about preventing such diseases so that the citizens enjoy a better quality of life. Then the efficiency factor of the environment, which facilitates various human activities and movement, which also comprises of the logistics, the public transport system, etc. Then the creation of environment, which maximizes people's comfort and enjoyment of living. This would include the aesthetics of a particular township and the privacy of individuals. Now, environment quality would mean different things to different people. For example, if there are elderly people living, they would be more concerned about the public transport system, you know, because they are dependent on it. So it depends from person to person, and the quality of environment, the perception would differ according to different individuals and their current state of mind. In environment quality management, we study the tools available and the actions required for managing environmental quality. The very first thing that comes under the purview of EQM is environmental management planning. A holistic environmental planning, taking into account the existing social realities, is very, very crucial for environmental quality management. For this, we need to take into account the following aspects. Number one would be human population. Now, a very careful planning of how we conserve and preserve our ecosystems is required, especially in the times when our human population continues to increase, not only at a social level, at a local level, but also on a global level. So it's very, very important that human population is taken into account whenever we plan the environment management. The next thing would be sustainability. Now, sustainability, we have already studied. The planning decisions we make today and in the near future will greatly impact the quality of environment which we leave for our future generations. So it is very important that the concepts of environmental impact analysis, the mitigation of adverse environmental impact, and environmentally compatible land use planning methods are actually studied in detail while we plan. The next is global perspective. Now we all know that we are staying or living in an era of post-globalization. The whole world, you know, has become a small global village. So it is very important that all of our environmental planning must have a global perspective. Development of international environmental agreements, despite the conflicting interests, is becoming increasingly important. So are the continuing efforts in global environmental forecasting. The next and very important point to be considered while EMP is urbanization. Now, we all know that there's a large-scale migration of population towards cities and other urban areas. These areas thus need more attention when it comes to the environmental issues. One of our most pressing environmental needs would be to ensure that our urban environments are carefully planned to maximize human well-being and to minimize the effects of natural hazards and pollution of the life-sustaining environmental elements, namely the air, water, and land. The next would be newer and emerging technologies. Now, we all know that the modern technologies are extremely beneficial to us. But at the same time, there are certain harmful effects of the same. We talk about mobile phones these days. the radiation that it emits, you know, is very, very harmful for our body and mind as well. So we need to take care that the residual damaging effects of industrial revolution on the environment, we need to take care that the emerging technologies are dealt with utmost caution, and after weighing their benefits vis-a-vis the environmental costs that are incurred by them. The last would be values and knowledge, which is again very important. Now, since we value our environment both at the local levels and global levels, it is very essential to develop new and relevant knowledge, tools and technologies to assist in the environmental planning process. So there would be people who would want to conserve and preserve the environment, and there would be some who would want to use it to their own benefit. So there has to be an environmental mediation that can help resolve these conflicts when values collide. The next and very important topic is environmental impact assessment. Now, this is an analysis of changes produced by a developmental activity or project or action. We need to assess that if a factory is put up and the production starts, then what is the harm that production process is actually trying to make to the environment around? The areas of EIA study would be land use, water quality, and rest you can see on the slide. The detailed notes I've already sent to you. Since there are so many areas of study in EIA, it is very important that there should be an interdisciplinary team which actually studies it, and it should have experts from various disciplines so that the approach is unbiased. And these teams and these experts, they provide recommendations and suggest ways and means to make the project beneficial to both human and the environment. There are stages of EIA as we see here, and these stages are very, very important while we assess the impact of such production processes on the environment. The first is baseline conditions. What are baseline conditions now? So baseline conditions involve the study of the existing total environmental conditions in the area where the proposed project is to be undertaken. The general practice would be to take the area which falls within a 10 kilometers of radius of the project. Second would be scoping. Scoping is the process of early identification of environmental issues which are relevant, concerns, assessment methods, affected interests, and so on. The third would be EIA report, which is a draft. It is a concise report limited to addressing the main environmental issues. I have attached an EIA report draft along with your notes. You can please refer to that. The next would be mitigation measures. Now, mitigating measures are actions which reduce, avoid, or offset the potential adverse environmental consequences of the development activities, which is very important. The next is review of draft EIA report. The EIA report has to be reviewed with utmost caution, because not only the project proponent but also an independent body should be required to evaluate it. It is very necessary to see that all the key points have been covered, all the mitigating measures that have been mentioned have actually been implemented. Then of course we have impact monitoring. Environmental monitoring is one of the most important components of EIA. It is very essential